Fundamentally, our work is about understanding how it is that groups of neurons in our brain can actually lead to our perception, our thoughts, and our actions. We're really interested in why sometimes when we're doing a task, we might get it right, and other times we might get it wrong. That is, why can we sometimes have very good attention or very good focus, and other times we might sort of drift off and lose our concentration? All of this happens because of neurons in our brain. That is, from moment to moment, the neurons in our brain actually lead to our perception, our thought, and our actions. We think that if we could understand that connection between the neurons in our brain and our perceptions and thoughts and behaviors, we could solve some really substantial mysteries about how we're able to do the wonderful things we can, and also open up the door to some really revolutionary possibilities of treatments for disease, and potentially even enhancements of our cognitive abilities. Fundamentally, brain science is a really young field, and that means a lot of the tools we have to repair problems with the brain or enhance our abilities are what you might think of as blunt tools. Really, what we'd like to do is make them much more precise. And we think that if we can do that, that would open the door to lots of new methods to repair problems with the brain and also enhance our cognitive abilities. If a human were performing a task, let's say monitoring a security camera, it would be ideal if they could have good attention and concentration continuously while they did that. And so understanding the link between our thoughts and our actions could really help if we were trying to, for instance, make a way for the human to better do that task. But it turns out that problems that we have in our brain often lead to failures or disorders in the same kind of abilities. So we think that understanding the link between our brains and our behavior could have this sort of dual purpose of both enhancing or having the potential to enhance our cognitive abilities and leading to new therapies and repairs for problems with the nervous system. The basic science and engineering that we work on is pushing forward all the time, and we're always trying to answer new questions and come up with new methods to understand what's going on in the brain. The applications to human health are a little bit farther than that, but we're always pushing in that direction. And we think that creative science and engineering can lead to applications that are the ones that we imagine, but also really important ones that are beyond what we're imagining right now. One of the challenges that we're facing now, and I think it's going to become an even more important challenge in the coming years, is bringing together people who are thinking about experiments and how to actually observe and see what's going on inside the brain with people who are thinking about computation, about the principles of how the brain acts and what it does. And I think we're doing this every day at Carnegie Mellon, and I'm really interested in trying to push these two things together to see what we can get by leveraging the expertise on both sides. Fundamentally, the thing that drives me about my work is that we are our brains. That is, everything we think and everything we do comes from our brains. And I think that means that the science and engineering that we apply in the lab has the opportunity to uncover really deep mysteries about how our brains work, but also apply to clinical problems where there's disorders and diseases that we really don't have good ways to address right now.